Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick in the Philippines. Yeah, I've been, well, the internet's been down almost 24 hours here. But, you know, thank the Lord it's not down more than it is. That's pretty typical. As I mentioned, I tried to get this other internet, but to get one that's faster than one I got, it's a whole lot higher. And I thought maybe since it was new, the other one is through the cable and it's new. And I thought, well, it might not be as reliable because it's kind of new, but... I guess I should have went with it because my other one has been down now for a day. And it goes down here and there, but never been down this long before, hardly completely down. Sometimes it's been so slow I could only email, but at least I could at least check my email and stuff. But anyway, brothers and sisters, if you're seeing this, I was able to load it. I just wanted to, I think I made a musical presentation about the Christmas parties and stuff, and I don't think I made a slideshow. So let's get started here, brothers and sisters. For those of you who thank the Lord, those of you who are interested in other things besides only the rapture and when it's going to be, I thank the Lord for all brothers and sisters who God, you know, put it in your heart to be involved with Joshua's ministry or even any ministry, you know, to do the work of God instead of, you know, just sitting around waiting for the rapture, that we would be busy about his kingdom, you know. And there's people who will comment and ask me sometimes, well, if you believe the rapture is imminent, why are you build an orphanage? Well, because we get rewards for the things we do for the Lord, and it's not only for that reason. We do it because I don't want to get into a big teaching. Let me say this. Lots of people are helping with Joshua's ministry because they love children, okay? But it's much more important than the fact that we love children. Even though that in the flesh and to human and humanism, you know, promoting mankind, that's a great thing, you know. To go to the Philippines to win the lost, that's not what we're called to do, brothers and sisters. We're called to bring glory to God. And then God's greatest purpose for us is to be conformed to the image of Christ. And so the process of bringing glory to God, which is the most ultimate calling, high calling we have, and to be conformed to the image of Christ. The process of that is when we do things that God called us to do, what we've been predestined to do as a Christian. God predestines those who would become Christians, whom he foreknew he predestined. So those God knew that I would say yes to being a Christian, and God knew I would say yes to be a preacher, and God knew I would say yes to come to the Philippines. So God predestined a life for me. God predestined all of you guys who's helped with Joshua's ministry, or whoever will help with Joshua's ministry. God predestined you and gave you your life. And everything is connected to a desire to help with orphans and things like that. And that's just how God just brings things together, just like with any other ministry that's God done. God brings people together with like-mindedness, you know, like those who have a calling to fight abortion. You know, God has called them in that area. That's where they work at, whatever it may be. So anyway, let me not preach because I only have 15 minutes to do this video with this screen-o-matic. So these are the three siblings who live with their mom, and there's no dad. The dad's run off. And all of them have the middle name Paul. That's the boy. There's two boys, and the oldest one is a girl. There she is. And that's the same boy that was in the first slide. And this is at the Christmas party we had in the front. Look at this boy's face. That's his smile. They said that's the way he smiles. So it's kind of funny. And this is in the most farthest away place from me. It's about 3 hours away. And we're at the church there. And there's a kindergarten class there. And Joshua was in that kindergarten class. He was staying during the week with his aunt, my wife's sister, and her husband, because they can't have children. So Joshua was staying with them during the week and going to this Christian kindergarten school that's free. You know, and they have a sponsorship program, you know, where people, you know, sponsor children to go there. Mostly it's a German guy who started that. Not a missionary, but a German who's a Christian. He started a group for this thing, and then it's just been perpetuated. They have about 40 or 50 kids. So that's the place we were at there, at that church / kinder 1 and 2 school there. And that's where we had there's his face too. It's pretty good pictures of him. He's excited to have his tennis shoes. There's the girl. These are the three our brothers and sisters. There's her shoes again. Okay, and there's Michael, and, you know, he's a new one, and he's also one with a mom. The dad is there, but he's sickly, got all kinds of medical issues and all this, and he's a lot older, and he's, you know, in late stages of life, and for whatever reason. So you know, the Lord just connected us. This is a Christian woman. And the thing about it is lots of times we keep helping people that are not Christians. You know, it seems that we always do that. All the feedings we do is always the kids of the drunks and the bums and all that. So it's really in my heart from the Lord to try to help poor Christians, you know, just like in the book of Acts. We see in the beginning of the book of Acts, they gave to each other, not to the world. Of course, we're given to the world for a purpose of opening the door for evangelism. But we're supposed to also give charity to our brothers and sisters, you know, to show the love of Christ, you know, and then be his hands, be his feet, be his, you know, mouth to speak and all those things. The body of Christ. These are some of the other things that we gave to that little one-year-old child, Michael. He's just 1 year old in December. Okay, and then there they are again, you know, and they have sponsors. These are some of the children from the feeding program. As I mentioned, if you've watched my video I made from this location, somehow they never had a camera before. The pastor there, Pastor Raul and his wife, Sister Daisy, who do one of the feeding programs for us, they never had a camera before, and somehow the memory chip got messed up. And I tried to reformat it to make it work, and I erased all the pictures they had taken that morning of these kids at a big feeding. They fed, like, I think it's 60 kids, 850 or 60 kids, and then I had ended up buying a new memory chip. But anyway, the pictures were still on there. It's just that they, you know, it wasn't working right. It was saying there was a lot more, less pictures than there were and all this stuff. Some kind of electrical glitch in there, whatever. It got some kind of a power surge or something. But anyway, so some of the kids came there after we'd had a second feeding for the church members and the pastors and that are doing the feeding, you know. And then some of the kids came back. Here they are, the very poor people, and I took some pictures of them so you can see. I mean, they're dressed in their best clothes to come up there. I mean, that's it. And yet lots of them still don't even have shoes and stuff. And this is just typical. Like I said, they're wearing their best to come to the Christmas party. And so they don't have, you know, they're really poor people, and they live in a beyond a shack. I've had videos and pictures of some of the places where these kids live. And they play in the water, in the river all day, you know. Maybe their mom does laundry for people and they wash the clothes in the river. That's the youngest son of Pastor Raul and Sister Daisy. And I'm also, you know, that's what I was going to say. I think I mentioned it in the video. I made a video saying, you know, here's the pastors and their kids don't even have food and stuff like that. This is their youngest son. They've got a bunch of kids, you know. This is their youngest son. And I'm looking for a sponsor for him. His name is Jairo. And he's kind of a naughty boy. But, you know, he's just a typical boy. You can tell by his face that he's looking to get into some mischievous trouble there. But anyway, I'm looking for a sponsor for him also. And, you know, because like I said, we keep sponsoring these non-believers, and this guy's the son of a pastor, and they don't have really anything. You know, the dad and mom, you know, only went maybe through elementary school. And their oldest children are in the ministry, and their oldest daughter works with me here and does some things here. She translates for me here when we go locally and do some evangelism / giveaway, which I've got pictures I'll show you. I got to keep moving. Looking for a sponsor for him. Okay, there's Sister Daisy giving out some rice. This is the boy that I had in the video. That's the grandson. This is the grandson of this Pastor Raul. Here's their son, their oldest child, Joseph, and he's a pastor. Okay, and here's their child. Here's his child with his bad, you know, feet, crooked feet. And somebody's already given some for him, and I pray, you know, that we have a full-time sponsor for him. Each of these kids, even though they have their parents are pastors and stuff, serving the Lord. I would like to give like $20, $25 a month for each kid, a part-time sponsorship like we're doing with those kids that don't have a dad, you know, who are non-believers. Okay, there's some of those kids. I'm always running late, guys. I don't know if I showed these before or not, except for in a slideshow. Oh, that was John there at the orphanage, John Ray. Anyway, here's some kids. I just got through running, if you know. I didn't mean to have my... I wanted to be in there. I didn't realize. I just got through running, and where I run at, I run right past for these lots of these poor areas, and I always try to stop, and I drink water there. They have these water pumps that you pump water, and I drink water, and I keep, you know, trying to evangelize and talk to people everywhere I go, because I've been living in this same place for 3.5 years. Anyway, see, these are some of the kids. They're hardworking kids. This boy drives a boat to ferry people across this river because they had a bridge there, and it keeps collapsing. A footbridge, and then he's driving a boat there. His dad is a fisherman. He takes a boat and goes back and forth, and then, you know, you give him like a peso each way, which is like 2 cents, and that's what he does, like, for a living, you know, when he's not in school. And I think he's about the sixth grade, maybe fifth grade. And anyway, these are some of his cousins that live near him. And so I invited them because I didn't have time to go back to their area. And then I gave them a box full of stuff to take there and give. And they've got like a little compound area there. And they're very poor people. And they got like about five houses. So I gave them a box full of stuff. Various things for their families. And then this is me when I went to these other people where I run in a different location. And they have, a lot of the kids weren't there, but this family has like 10 kids and they're all girls, no boys at all. And the oldest one's probably about 20 and she's was a helper for people somewhere in the city of Davao. And then that's the only thing they got. And the dad, you know, they're farmers. And then the land where they farm is like somebody else owns it and it's just like they just let them use it. And now the land's been sold for a mall. They're going to build a mall near my place. And then these guys, they had to go beg around to find another place to plant vegetables. And then I think I might have accidentally said the Filipino word, but vegetables is what they grow. And anyway, they have a smaller area now. It's not even, you know, like 10 by 10 feet maybe. So it's not hardly enough vegetables to sustain them. So these guys are hardworking. Those kids get out there and work in the vegetables every day. I see them all the time. And they're hardworking people, and that's why I gave them a box also, and then I evangelized them and prayed for them, and, you know, to receive the Lord. And, you know, I would love to sponsor this family, you know, as a group, you know, if I could get someone that would give $20 a month or something just because they're just, you know, their only thing they got is just working this vegetables, and they're hard workers, hardworking family. That's the mom, and they live in a nipa hut, but they've got it, what they call a nipa hut, made out of coconut leaves and all that, but they've got it nice, looking pretty good, but don't be fooled. It's a coconut hut there, and this is the bamboo flooring. And you know, it's just a little, see, that's their floor they walk on, and it's pretty thin. I didn't walk inside there. I might fall through, you know. Most of the Filipinos are pretty light compared to Americans, especially me, you know. Kind of big. Anyway, so that's the kind of stuff I gave them. Also another box. And this is another child I'm looking for some kind of a part-time sponsor. They got about six kids. I've never seen the dad around there, and they can't speak any English, of course. This is a child, and he's got something wrong with him, some kind of disease. I gave them a box. I prayed for them. His older sister, you know, he's still a little bit young. The older sister received the Lord, you know, and they never even heard the gospel, never even heard the gospel at all. This family, it's very rare that you meet people who's never heard the gospel. They had never heard the gospel, and that's the boy's got something wrong with him. I'm trying to think of his name right now. I can't think of it, but anyway, I would love to have a sponsor for him. It's malnourished. Probably give him. I'd love to see him have a multivitamin every day. There's the sister, the oldest sister. Her name is Mimi, and she received the Lord. And they're all siblings there. And that's all of them. And then that's me. I stuck my face in there. My sister-in-law was actually translating for me this time, and I asked her to take a picture, just so I could be in the picture with them to remember them, because they're very nice. All these people are so nice people. Good people, guys. And, you know, this, I'm just showing you this so you can see what Joshua's ministry is doing, you know. I used some of the money that people donated and bought this stuff and went there and gave it. And I was doing it myself out of my own money before. And now I can give more because, you know, you guys have donated. So I'm showing you what you've done. You know, what we've done for the Lord as a group. Okay. Now I prayed with him about his legs. And I believe for him to be healed. But I believe he also has some kind of malnourishment or something. I don't know. Just pray for him. And I'll find out his name. I'll find out his name and I'll put it under the bottom. I can't remember what it is. My sister-in-law, maybe she'll remember. I'll ask her. Anyway, there they are. And then this is one of our feeding programs from a couple weeks back. Just don't forget that we have the feeding programs. Oh, there's me with the orphans, which I've already shown. There's Joni. She's always a character. That's me at the orphanage, and I think it's in the video slideshow I made, but not in a not like where I'm talking. And some of the kids eating at the other Christmas party we had. There they are cooking. I got another minute left on this video. Those kids are just typical, you know. They're just, you know, they don't have much. And there's Pastor Romai, the other pastor, and his wife. They have a daughter that's autistic. And she hasn't been diagnosed yet. They're trying to get her diagnosed. She's about 7 or 8 years old, and she's definitely autistic. And, you know, I showed her in the video, too. I'm looking for a sponsor. Her name is Sila. They call her Sai is her nickname, Sila. And I would love to have a sponsor for her also, a part-time sponsor. And anyway, brothers and sisters, that's all the photos, and that's all the time that I have. And God bless you. Thank you all, the sponsors. Love you guys. The Lord's been showing me lots of stuff. The Lord's coming soon. The Lord told me to study Matthew chapter 24 this morning when I woke up. So, I'm working on that, and lots of